K2390, good luck. Not played before, no head-to-head score there. Opponent only 62 games, very high rating. That this could be somebody actually still underrated if you've built a rating to that level with that few games. So this could be a difficult game, but we'll just see. That's the fun of chess. That's the kind of traditional Reti principle, but I think I'm going to vary and go e3. How do I want to do this? Yeah, I'm going to go d4 and charge the centre. Try and get the knight into play. I'm not sure quite where. Where do I want to go? Let's go to c3. Knight in. I'm happy to trade that first knight. See, we're both playing this a little bit on the quick side right now. Bishop up, and I can do get rid of the bishop. He's going to play f5, I would guess. So bishop up f5. Is knight forward a move? With an idea for f3. I'm going to do that. I expect this, and I'll probably go forward. It might get a bit spicy. If he goes f5, I can always trade a pawn first. It isolates that pawn, then I can jump up. But my idea was to go here, then f3. So knight up, knight takes, pawn takes. I like the look of that, so I'm going to play it. It might be a mistake or a blunder, but I'm going to do it. My idea is just to simply go f3 here. See, if takes, I've got the option to take back either way. I guess it's a safe pre-move to take the bishop. I didn't expect it, but he's doing it. Okay, so now my queen is hanging, so I guess we just take back. Queen down is a natural move. I don't want to trade the queen, so I'm going to do that. Okay. Now, if I go here and he doubles up, I'm probably going to go something like this. Otherwise, the queen down is annoying. So I'm going to do that with an idea to play rook across, and I need to push one of these pawns at some point. Okay, he has played that. So does it matter which rook I do? Because I could try and do something like this. Stick to my instincts and do this one. I've just got to watch out for an attack on this pawn now. Maybe I could even drop the bishop back or the bishop forward. Or even just here to attack the queen. That's what he's done. So I thought maybe just here. Keep it simple. Let's do that. Bishop down might be a move. But I think I'm quite happy to trade there. I'm not sure. It does maybe weaken this pawn. But his bishop's not really doing anything here. So what's wrong with... Well, actually, if I drop back, he's activating his rook in here. It is actually doing something. So maybe I go here and encourage pawn forward. Then we can drop back. Then rook down. Then maybe a move like queen up. But if I drop down and the rook comes in, I'm going to have to trade. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to go here and try and encourage this. And then I think drop all the way back. I don't have the option to go back here now. If I go here, I lose the pawn. But then I've got rook across. Attacking the queen, so... Let's see. I've got to spend a move pushing a pawn in order to give my king a bailout square. My opponent's kind of already got one. But I'm threatening a move like queen up here to hit the pawn. So he's played the rook across. So he wants to double up. That's kind of logical and obvious now. So can I just push a pawn here and attack that rook? Take, take. Say you still double up. You're in a spot of bother there, so... What about pawn up here? If bishop takes rook across, you're in a pin. I guess you can move the queen here, but then bishop back, queen all the way back. I could put my holding move in. We know what move is going to come. But then I need to move a rook out of the way for when he kicks the bishop. Just like I'm getting a bit bogged down there, yeah. I'm going to sack a pawn and try and open things up. If he goes with a queen, I just play rook across. Goes with a bishop. I think rook across anywhere. But the queen is getting out. So I'm just trying to open things up a little bit. I've played bishop back. So now what about pawn forward? Then queen takes, bishop up. Pawn forward takes, rook across, queen takes, rook here. And then we try and target this pawn. I'm going to do it, why not? I'm trying to open the file up and activate a rook and get forward. Which might turn out to just lose the game, of course, but it's what I'm aiming to do. Probably still very risky to put my bishop here, so he has actually gone for it. Okay. So let's shift the rook. Now, do I shift the other rook and pile the pressure on both of them? That seems sensible, but it later on it might allow back rank check, but this rook's not really doing anything, so I'm going to do that. Let's go here and try and pile in on both. I really want this pawn just to try and weaken the structure of the three. That's what I'm aiming for. And at some point, this is going to happen and kick my bishop. Or it's likely to. But where does this queen go? Is the queen trapped, actually? Where does the queen go now? There's no escape anywhere. I think the queen's actually trapped. So the queen was trapped. So surely I've got to take the queen rather than this. So I'm going to take the queen. So now I definitely have to give myself a bailout square, but this is still not an easy formality. So what about rook here to stop rook coming across? But these pawns can just march down the board, can't they? But I'm going to go here, potentially get four, but I have to give my king a bailout square, but not easy to do. You can imagine if both rooks get here, not easy to defend this. But it feels like I need g3. It feels like g3 because of the dark squared bishop. Maybe h4, this is a risk. Oh, he's gone there anyway. Well, surely I must trade there. I'm doing that. Right, now I've done my emergency square. So these pawns are going to fly down the board. It's whether I can create any form of counterplay. Did I just miss there? Yeah, he had bishop back anyway, so it wasn't actually a miss. So I think I need a move like queen across here. Well, hold on, I've got queen here to hit two pawns, haven't I? And I stopped the rook check. So let's go here to hit two pawns. We are two pawns down, but we've got the queen versus the two pieces. The king comes up, so we've got to take the pawn. So check and king up. If the bishop gets here, though, there's always potential here. It's, I say, never a formality, these positions, especially when you're playing someone who's higher rated. Now, how do I stop this? Is it actually possible to stop that? I don't know. Queen here to attack the rook, but it might be that the two pieces win the day because the king looks very safe. And how do I get to the king? I'm just looking at going here now, but you can still actually push a pawn. So I can't stop the next pawn push because the bishop guards the rook. So I need to maybe get the queen here. How on earth do I do that? I'm going to go here, but I can't stop at least one push. So I'm trying to do something like this to get the king, but the king feels very, very safe here. So, it might have actually been a mistake. So do I do this then? I'm going to push this pawn and try and just open these king's defense up. I have to try something. Okay, he's taken very quickly. So, let's come across, hit the pawn and threaten a check. I guess he can just push again. A check. If you go there, I'm coming in. Block, check. But you're still probably perfectly safe. Yeah, he's just pushed forward, ignoring it. So I have to check. I don't think I've got any other move. I think I'm actually probably worse here. It was probably looking better for me than what it actually was in reality. So if I take, you just come down, check, you step up, check. I don't think I can actually stop this. I don't think I can stop it. think I have to take, but I don't think I've got a repetition here. I think a repetition might be the best I can hope for. I don't think I've got one. There is a hit to this pawn, but the rook guards it. This pawn is only one off a queen with a rook check to promote, so I don't think I can stop it. I think pawn down just wins the game. Check, up, check. You have to go to one of them two. Just go here. Check here. Bishop blocks, check. It's whether I can get a triangulation in. I'm not sure I can, but I don't think I've got anything else. So yeah, maybe I might have been better taking the rook, not the queen. Taking the queen might have actually cost me the game. That's a bit unfortunate. If I could just get this pawn, I'd probably be better, but I'm not seeing how we do it unless my opponent gets really, really risky to the point that they risk losing the game, but there's no need to do that. Well, let's just worry about my move when it is my move then. See, I'm expecting pawn down. That's the move I would expect. I can't take this, and you could just queen anywhere. I can't go back to stop. You could just rook check and queen next move anyway. So my only option is to throw checks in. Only option. If you block, check here. If you run, check here. So, I say just worry about it when it's my move. I wonder if he can actually move his bishop. That gives the king a square, doesn't it? Yeah. Yeah, he has found that move. So check, I think, is my only move. I don't think I've got another option here. And then check here is my only other move. I've got no other option. Well, if I go there, you just simply check up and queen. So nothing to think about. You've got two moves. So he's gone there. So I just have to check and repeat. Well, it's a draw. It's a draw then. Okay, be interesting to review that one back.